Hello and welcome to the first of the Google SketchUp object importing tutorials. These tutorials are made with the assumption that you already have SketchUp installed. If you do not, simply go to Google and type in SketchUp. The first thing you need to do is install the SketchUp ASE Exporter plugin. I'm getting mine from Wicked HQ. If you can't find it yourself, there is a link to the Wicked HQ download on the forums. So you download and open with WinZip. Once it is downloaded, you extract it to your SketchUp plugins directory. Okay, so extract, then C, Program Files, Google, SketchUp, and Plugins. Okay, you can also type the directory in here if you wish, and then click extract. Okay, that's it extracted now, so now you need to set up your default texture. To do that, you go to your C drive and create a new folder called UT3. That's U for Unreal, T for Tournament, and the number 3, so UT3. Then open up Paint. I like my textures to be a nice obvious colour, so make this one pink. And any textures you create need to be 256 by 256 pixels or multiples of that, so 512 or 1024 pixels is fine. Okay, this one's already 256 by 256 pixels, and as it's just a default texture, that's fine. So then you save it as a BMP in your UT3 directory, so C and then UT3, and set it to be a bitmap. Okay, I like to use 24-bit bitmaps. Okay, so that's, and you need to call it TOTO, so toto.bmp, and that's the default texture set up. So now you need to go into SketchUp. Okay, the template doesn't really matter, but as I'm used to using the metric system, I'll select simple template in meters. Okay, that's the plugin there. Okay, everything looks okay. So what we need to do is grab a model, so get models, and type in what you're looking for. I'm going for a Ford Mustang. Okay, and I'll go for this one that was created by Mirza. Okay, so just click on download model and load this directly into your SketchUp model. Okay, the person provides a good sense of scale, so as you can see, this car is very, very small. So you need to go to Tools and Scale and just click on one of the corners and drag it until it's the right kind of size you're looking for. Okay, that should be fine. Now you can use the pan to move left and right, or the orbit to move around the objects. Okay, so that looks fine. So what we need to do now is move the car onto the origin. Now this is quite important because any object you import from SketchUp will rotate about the origin. So just click on the move button and place it on the origin. Okay, that's fine. Now you also need to delete the person at this point, otherwise they will be exported into MovieZoo with the rest of the model. Okay, so that's the car in SketchUp, the right kind of size, and placed on the origin. So you go to your plugins and export an ASE format. Now you can just leave these as the default for now and call it whatever you wish. I'm calling it Mustang 3, and you need to put in the .ASE extension here. So save that, and as you can see, it's processing. Now this may take a few minutes depending on the complexity of the model and the speed of your PC. Okay, that's it exported now. So now we need to go into Move Easer. Here's a couple that I tried earlier on. And go to Create Objects and Import. And just browse for the object you've just exported. So Mustang 3. And set it to Use ID Textures. And double-sided facing. Now the ID textures do have other functions, but they'll be covered in a later tutorial. Now again, this can take a few minutes depending on the speed of your machine and the complexity of the model, so just please be patient. Okay, that's it imported now, and as you can see, it's the nice pink colour that we created earlier on. So what we need to do first is right click on it, and these colour pickers are all a bit random at the moment, unfortunately. So we'll just try and sort that out. As you can see, the first one is the body, so set that to red. Okay, that's the headlights, so set them to light yellow. Okay, that is the wheel hubs, so set them to dark grey. It's the wheel trims, so set them to light grey. That's the main body trim, so set that to black. That's the rest of the body trim, so that can stay black as well. That's the indicators, so set them to orange. Okay, that's probably one of the rear lights. Yes, it's the rear fog lights, so that's fine as dark red. Okay, that's an object in the front, so it's probably the, yes, the Cobra, so set that to light grey. That's the front fog, so set that to light yellow. Meaning the last one must be the rear lights, so they can be dark red. Okay, that's the colour sorted out. And as you can see, it's actually sinking into the ground a bit, and that's because SketchUp models generally don't have their collision generated correctly. So disable keep upright and enable floats in air, and you can lift the object up and rotate it until it's looking right. We will be covering adding proper collision in a later tutorial. Okay, it can be a bit awkward, so it may take a few attempts to get it looking right. But as long as you placed it on the origin earlier on, it shouldn't be too difficult. Okay, just need to bring the nose down a bit. Okay, that's almost it. That's it now. So here we have it, one Ford Mustang imported to Movizu from Google SketchUp.